Yes, I do.
Guys, let's get quiet so we can get started.
Our story begins once and upon a time in a little village here at the North Pole called Christmas Town. Now this town is unique for two reasons. One, there's no Starbucks. And two, everyone who lives here is an elf. Christmas elves enjoy themselves by donning the elf apparel or by singing songs to the thrift shop. Of course, I always like it when they sing a Christmas carol. I like it even better when they stop. Night and day, they dance and play. They never sleep much either. Once and twice, they cry. Of course, I love each one of them, but Santa needs a breather because they're just so happy all the time. They're oddly
happy all the time.
Ungodly. Now there's an elf called Buddy who makes them look apathetic.
If he were any sweeter, he'd not have to die of headache.
He's everybody's body, but he doesn't hear no screaming.
But everywhere he goes, he has to tell them who he's singing.
I'm singing. It's almost Christmas and I'm singing. And I love Santa, so I'm singing. Santa!
You know, Buddy, that's my thing.
Can I sing now?
Sure.
You know I'm happy all the time. Hello, I'm happy all the time. Great Christmas Town is heaven. So hello from Cloud 11. I'm so happy all the time. Don't know, I'm happy all the time.
He's tricky happy all the time.
Yay! Time to go work! Yay!
Buddy, get up. You have toys made. The big day is only 2 weeks away.
Did I mention I'm
happy all the time?
Now attention.
Happy all the time.
Making toys is so appealing that I spend each morning squealing.
He's happy all the time.
No, wait.
Happy all the time. He's all naturally happy all the time. Happy, 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 happy all the time.
There was this young lady, and
Embrace him. I love him.
Really? Where is he? Is it Charlie?
No, buddy, it's you. It's your story.
I'm not an elf. I'm a human. And I'm an orphan. Just like Annie.
You have a human father. And he works right there. He's an executive. He helps his children, of course. But, to tell you, he's on the naughty list.
No! What did he do? Did he go to bed?
He just doesn't believe in me anymore. He's lost the Christmas spirit.
But the Christmas spirit was Exodus 25.
I know, buddy. It's funny what they're doing.
Okay, which direction is New York?
Buddy, we live in the North Pole. It's south. Everything is south.
Perfect combination.
Why?
Because two whole pages from the last chapter are missing.
What?
Without them, the end of the book makes no sense.
Dead.
Yes, Mr. Hobbs?
Coffee, now.
Right away.
Hi, darling. Good morning, Dad.
Ready to go?
Go where?
Christmas shopping. Remember?
I can't. I'm swamped.
It's well documented that children of workaholics are prone to self-esteem issues.
Please continue this delightful conversation over here.
Excuse me. I'm here to see Walt Hobbs. I'm Buddy the Elf.
Buddy the Elf? So what am I? Who sent you?
Santa.
Santa?
From the North Pole.
I'm sure Mr. Hobbs would be delighted to meet you, but he's in a meeting right now. Would you mind waiting for a few minutes?
Sure.
Can I get you anything? A coffee?
Chocolate milk would be fantastic.
You're making it sound like it's my fault. It is possible, isn't it?
Oh, yes, Mr. Hobbs.
Dad!
Oh, boy.
Who are you? What?
Meet Buddy the Elf.
Well, aren't you gonna sing a song or something?
A song? Oh yeah, anything for you, Dad. I'm here with my dad, and we never met before, and you didn't know I was born, but I'm here now, Daddy. Guess what? I love you, I love you, I love you!
Call security.
Susan Wells had me. It didn't tell you, but now I'm here.
Susan Wells?
Isn't she the girl you went with in college?
Susan passed away years ago.
Deb, who sent this Christmas gram?
I don't know, Mrs. Hobbs. He came without a Christmas card.
Mrs. Hobbs, are you married to my dad?
I'm married to Mr. Hobbs.
Yay! Then you're my son, mommy. Would you like a hug?
No, thanks.
Wait, he's my brother?
Listen, buddy, some nice men are gonna take you far away from here.
But I wanna stay with you, Dad. Ouch, Mom, you pulled my hair.
I did. Oh, sorry.
You got a bob here, Mr. Hobbs.
Yes, this elf out of here.
Will do, sir. Let's go, buddy.
That's me.
I don't know. Take him to the North Pole.
The North Pole?
The Pole. You got it, Macy. I just gave him the North Pole. I want 3,480 miles. by singing loud for all to hear?
I don't sing.
Oh, come on! It's easy! I'm singing! I'm in a storm! And I'm singing!
All right, people! Santa will be arriving in 30 minutes, so stop standing around! Get this to work!
This isn't the right way to decorate for Christmas. You just gotta get into the Christmas spirit! We can do it! All of us together! There's a saying that we have up north. That helps to put our best foot forward. If you want to bet the halls for Mr. C, make sure they're sparkle and jolly and twinkle jingle-y.
What the heck is that supposed to mean? I don't know, probably more than usual, so not this baloney.
When a room is gloomy and its atmosphere has holly quits, then you must remember that December is the time for blitz. Never stop until each one on your Christmas tree is sparkle, jolly, twinkle, jingly. Pick up every ornament that's sitting waiting on a shelf. Why busy decorating? Why not decorate yourself? See to bring a smile to every person you'll see.
Sparkle, twinkle, jolly, what?
Close enough. And if you're at a loss, remember the phrase that says to thine own elf be true.
To thine own elf be true.
For when it comes to Christmas displays, look inside and you know what to do.
You know just what to do. Those cheery folks are all on every wall and every month. It's love each quarter.
Santa,
yeah, it's me, buddy, it's me.
No, buddy, how are you?
Please, have a heart. It's almost Christmas, and he's homeless.
Bye, dog, and Merry Christmas!
Bye, buddy.
Whoa, is this a turbine wind machine?
You know what it is?
Yeah, I built plenty in Santa's workshop.
So you know Santa pretty well, do you?
Yeah, Santa's like my best friend.
You still believe in all that flying reindeer stuff?
Of course not. Santa hasn't used reindeers in years. Now, the sleigh is powered by Christmas spirit alone. This is a problem for people like you. No tinsel? No tree? Have you even written your letter to Santa Claus yet?
Buddy, I'm sorry, but I'm a little too old to write to Santa Claus. Me too. Way too old. Anyhow, I'm gonna flunk on this stupid science project if I can't get it done.
Tell you what, if you get into the Christmas spirit and write your letter to Santa Claus right now, I'll fix your wind machine.
Deal.
So, how do we do this?
You're asking your 12-year-old son how to write a letter to Santa Claus? Well, what do you want for Christmas? I don't know. I know what I don't want for Christmas. Don't want a check. It's made out to cash or corporate free gift from some secret stash. I'd like a day with my dad. Just a day. Make that two. If you can do that, Santa, I'll believe in you. I don't want a check trip to some hip salon or a trendy perfume. I'll never.
Thank you.
down there, buddy. Got a lot of work to do.
Promise, I'll be your Christmas tree come true.
How? Oh,
they actually have a real Christmas. You see, you do have the Christmas spirit. Now, you have to spread it around. And the best way to spread Christmas cheer is by singing loud for all to hear. I told you, I don't sing for anyone at any time. This is for Christmas and especially Christmas. Come on, don't be singing, get me easy. Please stop. It's fun and free and best of all, it's totally cheesy. All you have to do is put your voice much higher. High, low, high, low. High, it's just the pocket was sustaining it to me. It's so pretty. Just sing a Christmas song. It's like magic if things go wrong. Just spread some Christmas cheer by singing loud for all to hear.
People are staring.
That's the point. Just sing a Christmas song and keep on singing all season long.
In love, and I don't care who knows.
Please, very busy.
Yeah, I need a table for two on Tom Green Christmas Eve dinners and $400.
The guy paid you a lot, Mr. Hobbs.
Buddy, we'll talk about this in a minute. Just do me a favor, sit in that chair and amuse yourself.
Oh, okay.
We'll bring the guy up here. I want to thank him personally.
Well, he's not waiting for a thank you. He's waiting for this.
$300,000?
Mr. Hobbs, we've been trying to get some story ideas. We've got nothing. We're idiots. And then this comes along. It's a gift from God.
God gets mad that he doesn't accept his gifts.
Fine. Write the guy a check.
Abuse myself.
Rima will understand, right? In fact, she'll be thrilled. There's gonna be Christmas bonuses for everybody. I mean, this is gonna make us billions. Where's Buddy? What's that noise?
No.
Where's the manuscript?
Snow!
Buddy, that was the only copy.
What?
That's it. I can't deal with this anymore. Go to the apartment, get your things, and leave.
But where?
I don't care. I don't care where you go. I don't care if you're an elf. I don't care if you're my son. Just get out of my life. Forever.
Thank you.
Thanks. Buddy, you are 2 hours late.
I have a really good explanation.
Go ahead.
I forgot about our date.
That's your explanation? You forgot?
Well, I remembered eventually, but for a very long time, I forgot. Which is why I'm late. Whoa.
Is
this tab on the room with all the pretty lights?
Yeah. And I'm sure some lucky couple had the most wonderful evening sitting at our table.
No, they didn't.
Why not?
Because we didn't have a table. I was going to ask my dad to get us one, but...
You forgot.
No, I remembered. But my dad got really mad at me for making it snow in this office.
Stop, just stop. I can't take any more of your crazy stories.
Toby, I'm so, so sorry about ruining your Christmas dream.
Forget about it. I just thought that if anyone could give me a real Christmas, it would be you.
Toby, I feel so bad about this. Sick to my stomach. I could swallow a zillion sticks of juicy fruit.
I don't want to talk about it anymore.
Can I give you a Christmas present?
Buddy, this is the worst possible time.
Here. This is what your roof looks like when it snows. Shake it. Pretty, huh? Those snowflakes are smaller than buildings. Keep it, and maybe look at it later when you're not curious. It's real special. I mean, you're not going to believe me, but Santa Claus gave it to me when I left the North Pole. Bye, Joby.
Oh, buddy. I so wish that were true.
work on Christmas Eve. Tough luck. So do I. Get it through your heads. We always on our way, and she has our fire pitch. We're all fired.
May I make a suggestion?
Anything.
Whenever we visited my granny in Budapest, she told us the story of little Palko, the one-legged boy. Every year on Christmas Eve, he wished and wished for a leg. And then one Christmas morning, there it was, under the tree, from Santa.
A leg.
Yes, a leg.
A human leg.
Yes, because you've been a very good boy.
That is the most disgusting story I have ever heard.
Well, it's incredibly touching if you hear it in this year.
Dad, you're not going to believe what I just saw! We have to talk, Walter, right now.
Deb, keep an eye out for Greenlow, will you?
First of all, Buddy's missing.
He left a note on the etch sketch.
Michael, you don't understand.
No, Dad, you don't understand. It's not just Buddy.
This is Greenway. How lovely to see you.
Please, I beg you to give me 10 minutes to make this pitch, and then I'll help you look for Buddy.
All right, make it quick. I gotta catch a plane back to Chicago.
Christmas party?
Hardly. Gotta fire somebody. You remember Mark Zenko and Accusations? He paid some con artist $300,000 of company money for a fake Christmas story. Now let's hear your pitch, and it better be good.
Okay, picture this. Christmas morning, under the tree, a little boy's leg.
He'll be forced to change his tune. It's a story of
want our Christmas story to be about a horse that goes to the North Pole.
Yeah. That's the stupidest thing I've ever heard!
Michael!
You're an idiot! Oh, come on, buddy, the Christmas horse!
Ma'am, I'm not a horse.
I've had enough of this. I don't need to be lectured by kids on how to sell books to the kids. You two, take your smart remarks and get out of here.
Sorry.
Sorry.
Wait. Miss Greenway, Buddy and Michael are my sons. I'd prefer if you did not insult them.
And I'd prefer that you keep your wife and your whole weirdo family out of this office and do your job. Now, you got a good idea here, Hobbs, so this is what we're going to do. We're going to stay here all night and all day tomorrow until we...
Tomorrow? Tomorrow's Christmas.
You got a problem with that?
Yes, I quit.
What?
I quit.
You want to spend Christmas on the unemployment line?
No, I want to spend Christmas with my family.
Aww.
Aww. You're weak, Hobbs. I haven't spent Christmas with my family in 30 years.
Miss Greenway,
what?
Merry Christmas.
I quit. I actually quit my job.
I've never been more proud of you, Walter.
Buddy! We saw him! We saw Santa Claus!
You did? He's flying around in his sleigh. Then he landed in Central Park. Walter is the most incredible... Why would he do that? Unless... the sleigh couldn't fly anymore. Santa warned me about this. We have to go find him. Come on!
Buddy!
Buddy, wait!
Michael, wait for your dad!
Thank you.
like Miss Mickey.
What? How did you know that?
And you are?
Yeah.
Christmas, 1916. A Bobby Rydell lunchbox.
I love Bobby Rydell. What is this? <Sunday? laughs>
What's your name?
Charlotte Denon. Do your one.
Charlotte Denon, New York. All right, here you go. This year, you want a Tiffany engagement ring, and your boyfriend, Dwayne, stop dragging his feet and pop the question.
Ooh! Did you just say that, my mother?
No, it's all right here.
Okay, that's it. I don't know how you're doing this, but I'm not an idiot. Everyone knows this is Santa Claus. Oh my gosh, it's Christmas.
You didn't ruin Christmas. No, I can't. Oh, I can stand here all night reading names out of this thing, and you still wouldn't believe him. Would you? It doesn't matter, because Christmas is a lot more than just Santa Claus. It's eating souvlaki with your girlfriend and getting your first kiss under that big glittery Christmas tree. It's traveling miles and miles to be with your family. And walking through the Lincoln Tunnel with cars blowing their horns and truck drivers saying they just had no intention ever said it. It's waking up on Christmas morning with all the cars, all the piles of garbage, and all the big gray office buildings will be covered in snow.